Class 10 students, today again we will discuss how to solve the quadratic equation by factorization method, that is solution of quadratic equation by factorization method. So let us some examples. Say for example, you are given 2x² + x - 300 = 0. So at first we have to factorize by splitting the middle term. So you multiply the constant term by the coefficient of x square. That is -300 × 2, you will get -600. So you find out the factors of 600 such that you will get 1. Okay, there is nothing which were 1. So let us see by 2, 2 3 is 6, 300 times by 2, 2 1 are 2, 10, 2 5 are 10, 0, by 2, 2 7 are 14, 10, 2 5 are 10. By 3, 3 to the 6, 1 remainder, 15, 3 times are 15. By 5, 5. Now let us see how you get 1. There is a minus sign. Huh? So in previous class, I taught you that in case of factorization, if the product is minus sign, then one factor is minus and other is plus. So let us see 2 to the 4, 2 to the 8, 8 is a 24. Then 5 5 is 25. Minus 25 minus 24. What do you get? 1. Then there is x. So what do you have? 25 into x, 25x minus 24 into x, 24 slightly. So ultimately what do you get? 1x. No? So there is a 1x. So that 1x you write in this form. 25x minus 24x minus 300 = 0. Now from this pair you take the common factor, only x is the common factor because there is x, there is x squared. Then from 25, 5 into 5, no more 2, so 2 cannot be taken as common factor. So there will be 2 and x, 2x plus, here already x is taken, 25. Then next let us see what is the common factor between 24 and 300. Inside the 300, is the 24 is the factor? Yes. In 300, 300 is started from here, you have seen that. Then what is the common factor you have seen from 300? 2 to the 4, 4 to the 12. 12 is inside the 300. So in 24 also 12 is there because you know that 24 means what? 2 into 12. Is it? So there is also 12 and inside the 300 also 12 is a factor. So that's why we take 12 as a common factor. If we take 12, by 12 we divide 24. 12 to the 24 minus minus plus. By 12, if you divide 300, this will be cancelled. 5 times are 25. Is it? Are you clear? 300 is divided by 12. 12 to the 24, 6 remainder, 60, 12 times are 60. Good. So next, take the common factor once, that is 2x plus 25. Whole into x minus 12 equal to 0. So in previous class we saw what is this? The product of these and this factor is 0. Why it will be 0? For some values of x, this will be 0. For some values of x, that will be 0. So let us see what is the value of x. So we will write either So you have to at first form the quadratic equation. So let us discuss such type of question. How do you solve this type of equation? So then, say for example, you and me solve. Question will be solve x minus 1 by x minus 2 plus x minus 3 by x minus 4 equal to 3 whole 1 by 3, but where x is not equal to 2 comma 4. X value should not be 2 and 4, because if it is 2, 2 minus 2 will be 0. If normal expression, then if it is 4, 4 minus 4 will be 0, so it will not be rational expression. So at first what we do, we simplify this, like the simplification of rational expression. No? We discuss it. At first we simplify, after simplification we will get the quadratic equation, then we solve it. So how do you simplify it? Already all of you know that we take the LCM of the denominator. What is the denominator here? X minus 2. Where is x minus 4? So let us take the LCM. There is no common factor. X minus 2 is one factor, and x minus 4 is another factor. So no more common factor. So that is why LCM will be what? Product of the denominator. That means we have to write x minus 2 whole into x minus 4. Next process is what? LCM is divided by denominator. It's a denominator. So what is the denominator you have seen here? X minus 2. So x minus 2 and x minus 2 will be cancelled. Then you multiply the numerator, x minus 1 whole into x minus 4. Plus, now again, you have to divide this LCM by this denominator. So what is the denominator here? X minus 4. So this x minus 4 and x minus 4 is cancelled. Then you multiply the x minus 3 whole into x minus 2 equal to 3 whole 1 by 3. Now let us multiply the numerator as well as denominator. This time we are multiplying the denominator also, because we need a quadratic equation. So let us multiply x into x, x square, x into minus 4, minus 4x, minus 1 into x, minus 1x, minus 1 into minus 4. What do you get? Plus 4. Then plus for x into x, x square, x into minus 2, minus 2x, minus 3 into x, minus 3x, minus 3 into minus 2, minus minus plus 3 into 2, 6. Next, then x into x, x square, denominator, x into minus 4, minus 4x, minus 2 into x, minus 2x, minus 2 into minus 4, minus into minus plus 2 into 4, 8 equal to, then you make it improper fraction. See, 3 is a 9, 9 plus 1, 10 by 3. Now let us add or subtract the numerator. So you have seen some similar terms. So let us see. X square plus x square. How many x square are there? X square plus x square. There is nothing in solution. You know there is 1 and there is 1. 1 plus 1 will get 2x square. Next, all are minus signs. So minus sign you put. Then you get 4 plus 1, 5. All are minus. Is it? So you need to give down the minus sign. Then you get all the minus 2 plus 1, 5. 5 plus 2. 7, 7 plus 3, 10x. Then 4 plus 6, again 10. Dividing by x square, minus 4, minus 2, minus square minus 10x plus 10 whole into 10 into x square minus 6x plus 2. Now let us multiply 3 into 6x square, 3 into 10, 30, 3 into 10, 30, 10 into x square, 10 x square, 10 into 6, 60x, 10 into 8, 80. Now let us transpose all these terms, left and right hand side now to left side. So 6x square minus 30x plus 30 minus 10x square. Sign will change. Plus become minus. Minus become plus. Plus become minus. There is nothing, so 0. So 6 minus 10 minus 10, so you put minus 4x square. Minus 30 plus 60. 60 minus 30, what you get? 30. Is it? So you write 30x. Then minus 80 plus 30. What you get? Minus. Minus is larger number, so minus 8 minus 3 is 50. So what you get? 30x minus 50 you get. Is it? From 30 you subtract 80, that is minus 50 equal to 0. So next you see, there is a minus sign. No? Then you know, never, don't write a minus sign in the front side. So let us take the common. So, we can take some numbers also. Suppose 4 is means what? 4 is 2, 2 is 4. 30 means what? By 2, 15. 50 means what? By 2, 25. That means every number has is a factor. So, minus 2 will take common. Then what we have? If we take common, then there will be 2x squared. Minus is taken. Minus, minus. Minus 8 plus become minus 15x. From 30 also we get 2. Then minus minus plus. From 50 also we take 2 as a common factor. Then 25 equal to 0. So next 2x square minus 15x plus 25 equal to 0. Since this 0 is divided by minus 2. Since 0 by minus 2 equal to 0. So, 0 is divisible by any number, always 0. So, next you see, we will get a quadratic equation 2x square minus 15x plus 25 equal to. So now let us see how to do it. Again the same process, 25 into 2, that is 50. We will factorize like this, then 5 plus 10, 10 plus 5, 15. So since there is a minus sign, so you write minus 10x, minus 5x, plus 25 equals to. After that, what you do? Again, the same process. You take the common factor of 2x squared and minus 10x. So 2 and inside 10 also 2 is there. Is it? So we take 2 as well as 2x. So there will be, if we take 2x from 2x squared, then there will be only x minus, by this 2 we divide it, 5 minus. By this 5, you divide it minus minus plus into minus minus 5 equal to 0. So x minus 5, then 2x minus 5 equal to 0. So either x minus 5 equal to 0, x equal to transpose the term 5, or 2x minus 5 equal to 0. 2x equal to 5 and x is equal to 5 by 2. These are the answer 2. Value we got 2 values. So what are the solution? Solution is 5, 11. So like this, you will be given quadratic equation. If direct equation you are given, then you solve it. And if you are given in this form, at first you simplify and make it quadratic equation. Why you simplify? At first you simplify to get a quadratic equation. You have to form a quadratic equation, and after that you have to solve it by the factorization method. So thank you all of you. You try from your